squadron, tighten formation. Slow approach, let's draw them in.
Yes, sir.
Don't worry, R2. Grievous is falling right into our trap.
When I think about Star Wars, an iconic element is always the space battle. I think that every kid I've ever known, from age 8 and up, has probably imagined he was in Luke's X-Wing assaulting the Death Star.
This is Red 5, I'm going in.
We really wanted to explore different kinds of space battles in the Clone Wars 2. This was a great opportunity to have a capital ship battle with fighters amidst the asteroid field. We haven't seen that before in Star Wars.
Ahsoka, they're in position. Unveil our little surprise.
Right away, Master. Rex, old boy, it's time you join the party.
With pleasure, sir.
That opening battle sequence was interesting because we had very few assets.
Oh,
so
yeah.
We wanted to have something that was a really dynamic battle, and so one of the things that we did have was the AT-TE tank. So we said, how can we make this battle really interesting? We thought, why not have the tanks be deployed in outer space, set up on these asteroids, and used to ambush Grievous?
General, we've been outflanked.
All units, fire at will!
This is too easy!
This episode was a great opportunity to explore Anakin's problem with attachments. Specifically, his relationship with R2-D2. I'm sure he's kind of like his best friend.
And George always says that R2's like that. He's like a, you know, the family dog, so.
Uh-oh.
When R2 gets lost, Anakin is determined to find him at any cost.
There's a scene I like where Anakin and Obi-Wan are talking, and Anakin's trying to convince Obi-Wan to let him go after R2.
I could take a squad out there, track him down.
Anakin, it's only a droid. You know attachment is not acceptable for a Jedi.
I wanted to shoot across Anakin and pick up Ahsoka watching this conversation. And I wanted to show that she's kind of studying these two, Anakin and Obi-Wan, and she's trying to sort out, well, these are both very good Jedi, which is the correct path here. And she actually comes to Anakin's support.
What possessed you not to erase that droid's memory?
Master Obi-Wan, sometimes R2 having that extra information has come in handy.
Well, then find that droid, Anakin. Our necks might very well depend on it.
Right away, Master.
R2 isn't on the scanners, but there is a ship out there.
We went through a couple of different designs for Vulture's Claw, but the one that got picked works best because of its paint job, and the paint job was inspired by a dump truck driving down the road one day, which was green and blue and really rusty and oily, and even though the design itself was done independently of a dump truck, the colors that the ship ended up being were based pretty much directly on one specific dump truck.
Ugh, what's that smell?
Gnacht was a fun character. He was a different kind of sleazy to Grievous. You know, he wasn't sort of the evil, conniving. He was just greedy.
I've got the merchandise you're looking for. Maybe it is worth more than we negotiated.
Don't push me, slime, or else.
I think Gnacht was probably the first character where there was a conscious choice to make an asymmetrical face. It's much easier to build one half of a head, flip it, stitch it together, and use that as your model. But with Gnacht, just to sort of show how sort of corrupt and, you know, untrustworthy this guy was, we wanted to have some sort of physical representation of how sort of twisted he was that would just tell you pretty much straight away that this was a bad guy. Yeah, he was one of the bad guys.
There is something weird in this episode, though. That I had nothing to do with, and you had nothing to do with. And I always say that I'm gonna give credit where credit's due. And that's when Gonok comes through the portal.
Right.
Not from here. I won't say who. Save to say the sound team.
This was bad.
Yeah, you go ahead. You talk to Matt Wood. You ask him about it. Oh! Did I say it?
Of course he mentioned the fart, didn't he?
you put him on a hot seat about that. He'll completely deny it, and he's a very cool customer. But you can get Dave Acord in here, too. You can crack him.
That's not going to be easy.
Now let's see how much I have here.
We have a fart track that we just sort of kind of up and down throughout the episodes. No.
No.
Oh, brother.